Hello there, my fellow Holotable heroes, and welcome to another Swoga video. So I'm back here with another Grand Arena Feeds guide. So we have Season 19, the join period kicking off tomorrow, and we are back to the 5v5 format. So this will be the first time that we will be playing 5v5 with the new expanded division in the Grand Arena Championship. The theme for the upcoming season is the Mandalorian, but that doesn't refer to the faction Mandalorians that we have, but rather to the TV show The Mandalorian. So all the feats will be themed around there. So as always, I'll go through the feats and then show you some of the suggested teams to achieve those. But as always, first off, there's a disclaimer to this because all of these feats are based on the data mine as well as my historic data. So obviously some of these probably will change slightly. So at the moment that they should just be used as a guideline. But as of these feeds become live throughout the season, I will be updating them to make sure that they reflect accurate information. Anyway, so first at the top, we've just got all the generic ones that we get every time that are not specific to the theme every season. And again, this is all projections, the starting dates and rewards based on the historic data that I gathered over the past year. And then at the bottom, for now, we do not know yet, we do not have information when these will start. So at the moment there, you will find them at the bottom of my feeds page. Again, if you haven't seen yet my Swagger for Life tool, there will be a link in the description below, so you can go ahead and check it out. As of these feeds go live, I will put them in the correct chronological order, wherever they fit in there. Anyways, let's start with the first one. This is the way. So in this one, we have to win a Grand Arena battle with a team containing Mandalorian and Armorer. Now, probably the best shot here would be because, you know, Mandalorian, he's a bounty hunter, that you just kind of put some sort of a bounty hunter team here together, because four of these are very, very good. And then the fifth one, you can just slot in Armorer so he can, you know, boost somebody else as well there. And as well, Jango is a Mandalorian here also, so Armor can also call both of these guys to assist. Can apply, obviously, the Beskar armor on them as well, so definitely a solid team here to achieve this feat. Up next, Wielders of the Darksaber. So here, we have to win a Grand Arena battle using the three characters that I guess do have wielded the Darksaber. So we got Gideon, Bo-Katan, and Sabine. So this is not or. All three of these guys have to be on the same team, and unfortunately, you know, there is very little synergy between Gideon and Bo-Katan. Okay, Sabine, I guess, and Bo-Katan, you could say, fine, they're Mandalorians, there is some synergy there, but Mandalorians, as of there now, the faction themselves are not very good. So maybe what you could do is maybe go down the Empire route, so kind of do Palpatine, Vader, Gideon. These three guys can do some big damage in Grand Arena, and Sabine and Bo-Katan can just come along for the ride. And similarly here, Darth Revan and Basti, these two characters can, you know, pretty much 2v5 a lot of the weaker teams in Grand Arena. So you slot in then Gideon as well, and then Bo and Sabine again, just, you know, free riding this one. And then finally, if you do have good Mandalorians, like if you do have Relict Kandorus, you could try something like this perhaps with Bo-Katan lead, Sabine and Kandorus. They're all Mandalorians, so they will all benefit from what Bo-Katan brings. Then you can bring in obviously Gideon. You have to bring him in to get the feat done. And finally, if you add in Watt, and then Watt puts on Kandorus weapon tech, Kandorus can do some big hits if he's Relict up. So just, you know, rough ideas here. And moving on, the Daring Plan feat. In this one, we'll have to win a Grand Arena battle with a team containing the Beskar Mandalorian, Kara, Grief, IG-11 and Quill. Now, this is actually quite a good team as well, because, you know, Grief aside, Beskar Mando, Kara, IG and Quill, these four, with the addition of maybe Nest or somebody, you know, they can do some serious damage because they can all feed Whistling Birds to Beskar Mando. They can even take out Grievous squads and things like that. And Grief himself, he's pretty good anyways. He's got some synergy with Scoundrels as well, because all of these guys are Scoundrels. So I think this team can definitely do some damage in Grand Arena. Maybe not versus top teams, but, you know, some of those medium and low-end teams, you shouldn't have issues completing this feat. Up next, I have spoken. We have to win a Grand Arena battle with Quill and IG-11. So this is very similar to the team above. We're just going to use standard Beskar Mandalorian scoundrel team. So we got all these key characters. Now here you can use Han, you can use Nest, really any sort of scoundrel that's got an AoE will slot in here nicely. And this team, if modded and relic'd correctly, can easily take out Grievous teams. Alright, where is your master? This one, we have to win a Grand Arena battle containing Thrawn and Ahsoka Fulcrum. Now fortunately there's absolutely no synergy between Thrawn and Fulcrum. So my guess would be just use your standard Empire lineup here with Palpatine, Vader, Watt and Thrawn, and Ahsoka can just come here for a free ride. Or you could do Sith Triumvirate with Thrawn. Again, this team, you know, maybe it's good to take out Padme and then, you know, Ahsoka Fulcrum can just kind of come along for the free ride yet again. Okay, so moving on, we've got the rescue feat. So for this one, we'll have to defeat 24 enemy units in Grand Arena with any of the following characters. So we got the Beskar Mandalorian, Bo-Katan, Kara, Boba, Gideon, Dark Trooper, and Jedi Knight Luke Skywalker. So you do not have to have all of these guys on the same team, but obviously if you do, it makes it easier because you don't have to time your hits. So again here, we're going to make a use of the standard Beskar Mandalorian scoundrel team. And here, for the fifth one, Boba can come in. He's a scoundrel, he's got an AoE. So again, this team potentially can as well take out Grievous. So definitely a good one there. Obviously, if you do go with the down the trooper route, just try to time the kills with Dark Trooper. If you do have him relic'd up, he's probably the one that will be doing most of the killing anyway. So definitely a good option there. And also a tip here, if you're going with troopers against Night Sisters, for example, you can just leave Zombie and another Night Sister alive, and then you can just keep killing Zombie over and over again, and that will count as defeats. So you could get, you know, a lot of hits in there, a lot of kills there with troopers versus Night Sisters. Alright, and then finally, obviously, Jedi Knight Luke, most likely if you just surround him with some sort of support and tank units, they won't really do a whole lot of damage, these guys, so you know, it probably will be quite easy to time hits with Jedi Knight Luke that he can defeat the enemies, not the other guys. So up next we got the Foundlings Are the Future. In this one we actually have to defeat only 12 enemy units, not 24 as in the previous one, and it has to be with any of the following characters. We got again Beskar Mandalorian, Jango, Mandalorian and Armorer. So here one way you could do is using Bounty Hunters. I was using Jango and Mandalorian. These guys are kind of the biggest damage dealers in Bounty Hunter squad anyway. Mandalorian obviously with his disintegrate and Jango with his big rocket hit. So just try to time those hits and you should be good to go. You could also go down the scoundrel route. So we got Beskar Mandalorian, Jango and Mandalorian, and then obviously IG and Quill. So again, these three guys will probably do most of the damage anyway. So that's how you can probably quickly and easily rake up those 12 enemy characters that you need to defeat. Alright guys, so this kind of rounds up the feats for the season 19 that we have upcoming. Now there are some feats that have been left out from the data mine, or at least, you know, they weren't pulled in. And as well CG, you know, they don't do any more their forum posts. But usually we would have in each season like two more feats. So one would be like, I don't know, a gain offense up 50 times or gain tenacity up 50 times or things like that. So those kind of two feats are still coming up, so we'll see, will it be offense up or will it be tenacity, or I think we had some other ones as well. Again, I'll be adding those as of when they go live to make sure that they are correct. And also there was no information on which of these feats they grant any title as the reward or portraits as well. So again, once those become live, I'll make sure to update all of this. So again, you'll be able to find the link to description below to this page here. So make sure to save it for later so you can anytime come back and review what's going on. But until then guys, thank you for watching. Have fun, enjoy your life, and may the RNG be with you, my friends.